rebuilt, how he comforted us in his word. Let's bless the name of the Lord. You see, let's praise him. The Bible says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Oh yes, those that are dead and they are in the grave now, they cannot praise the Lord. But we, the living, it is the duty that we hold. Our God, that his name be glorified in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Our Lord, our God, we thank you so much. What a privilege we have this evening to be partaker of this first service, revival service of the year. We thank you so much for how your mighty hand has supported and upheld us. How, Lord, you have comforted us. How this everlasting arm has been our shield, protecting us from every side. How this arm of God has been the very source of our provision and supply. And here we are this evening again. Lord, we have come to worship you again. And we know that every time we set time aside and we set ourselves aside to worship you, it is because we know that you will bless us. And Lord, even as we have left all the other things that we could be doing this evening, and we have come to fellowship with one another, with you in our midst, we pray that you will bless each and every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Mighty Lord and God, we pray that you will send forth your spirit this evening. Your spirit that reveals the deep mystery of your word. You will send it unto each and every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And Lord, we pray that we will receive that word with faith, with confidence, with assurance in the promise that never fails. And the dividend, the blessings that comes upon the life of those that believe you and take you at your word, we pray it will be ours in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As we are starting this year with you, Lord, this first revival service, we are praying, my Father, my God, that you will help us every step of the way. There are still more 50 revival service, 50 if you tarry this year. And Lord, we are asking that for every week as we come, you will feed us with the bread of life.
Amen.
And your name will be glorified in our lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord, for the answer.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
And the church of God says, amen. This evening, I welcome you again to this year, 2021. And it is my prayer that the Lord God of heaven that brought us into this year, he will support us, he will help us, so that as we make this journey in this new year, all the knowledge that we need to be able to make this year a success, the Lord will grant unto each and every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This evening, I want to talk to you on recovering the loss in the new year. And I know that it is possible for some of us to have lost some things. But I also know that whatever we have lost, if we trust God, it is possible for us to recover it. And I'm going to be reading my text from 1 Samuel chapter 13. It's a passage you are familiar with. So I'm not going to read the whole chapter. I'm going to pick just 3 verses there so that we can quickly go into the exhortation and we can have time to pray. In 1 Samuel chapter 30, you know the story, the tornado of the enemy's invasion had swept past the place of David, where he had his family, he had his everything, his cattle, everything. That was his space. That was his inheritance in the land of the living. It was in a place called Ziklag. And the enemy had come in their rage. David was not there, and they took the place over, invaded, destroyed things, took the family, wife, and children, as well as the property of David, and they made away with it. So by the time you come to verse 8, the Bible says the first thing that David did was to seek the face of God, just as we are here this evening. He inquired of the Lord to know that this thing that I have lost, is it possible for me to recover? Because God is so much. And I read in verse 8, and David, 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 8, and David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, and he, that is God, answered David, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover. The Lord gave him a promise, and he said to him, yes, believe me, go after what you have lost. You will catch up with it. You will overtake it. And everything that you have lost, you will recover. Let's come to verse 18. The fulfillment of the promise that God gave David, we find the fulfillment in verse 18. And David recovered all that the Amalekites had carried away. And David rescued his 2 wives. And in verse 19, there was nothing lacking to them, neither small nor great, neither sons nor daughters, neither spoil nor anything that they had taken to them. David recovered all. And my prayer tonight is that as God fulfilled the promise he made to David, even to you and me tonight, the promise of recovery for whatever we have lost last year and yesteryears, the Lord God of heaven will fulfill that promise in Jesus' name. Let me begin by asking you, have you ever lost something, anything? Something very valuable. I'm sure most of us will say yes. Well, it shouldn't surprise any one of us, because losses are part of human experience. And when they happen, they are usually very painful. There is nobody that you will find that he will tell you, I have never lost anything in my life. It doesn't happen. Losses, they are very, very normal. In fact, many times when we suffer losses, it's not just painful, but they also leave a void in our lives. Sometimes some of those things that we have lost, they are irreplaceable. They are irreversible. If somebody lost a loved one in death, that person is dead, is gone. But if it is something that is reversible, if it is something that is recoverable, many times we make effort, as much effort as possible, to see that we recover those things, especially when they are valuables, when they are precious things that we want so dearly. My prayer is that whatever loss it is that you have lost, it will not be permanent. It will be such that is reversible. It is such that is recoverable. And as the Lord helped David to recover his loss, the same way this year, he will help us to recover our loss in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brethren, what are the pathways? What are the steps that we need to take so that we can recover recoverable loss? We can recover reversible loss. Number one is that we must recognize that we have suffered a loss. I'm going to be quick. You have the outline. You can study it at your time. The first thing is that we must recognize it. We must acknowledge it. We must be aware that, yes, I have suffered a loss. Think about it. Somebody is walking away and going to somewhere, and he has lost money in his pocket or in his wallet. And even though they are saying that, look, we found something, and the person does not recognize or was not even aware that he has lost something, you know, the person will pass by and say, well, I don't know what you are talking about. Me, I've not lost anything. It is possible. And for you to be able to, you know, recover anything that is lost and found, you must recognize it so that when they raise the alarm that, look, oh, here we are, we have found something, you will say, oh, yes, I've been looking for it. I was aware that I lost it. So there must be a recognition of the loss. The second step that we need to take, brethren, we must also find out the reason for the loss. You should ask yourself, what happened? How did I lose this thing? Could it be that this, my pocket, is having holes that this money dropped and I didn't know? The reason is for you to prevent the same thing from happening so that you don't lose it again. So, number one, you must recognize that there's been a loss. Number two, you must know the reason why you lost it. And finally, there will be recovery of the lost. I said there will be recovery of the lost.
Amen.
And these three things is what I'm going to talk to you about briefly. And my prayer is that as we begin to trust God for recovery this evening, he will do unto us what he did for David in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come with me to point number one, recognition of the loss. I said it that except we are aware of the loss, we may not be able to pursue so as to recover. We may not be able to trust God and say, God, this thing that I have lost, please lead me to where I'm going to find it. Because there are some people that lose or lost something and they did not even know. And what should have been recoverable became a permanent loss as a result of it. And I pray that will not be you, that will not be me in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come with me to Revelation and hear the story of these people, how their situation and their confession contradicts each other. The way that they saw themselves was quite different from the way God saw them. In Revelation chapter 3, as I read here in verse 17, talking to this church, the Bible says something, and it's a shame, it's unfortunate, that it is possible for somebody to be blind, and yet he thought he can see. The Laodicean church got this word from the Lord, and it was a rebuke. In Revelation chapter 3, verse 17, the Bible says, because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods, and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked. Can you imagine? These people were busy telling everyone that, look, I have no need of nothing. I am blessed. I don't lack. Everything is okay in my life. And the word of the Lord came to them. They said that, look at us. We are very rich. We have no need of nothing. And the word of God says, how could that be? How come you didn't know? I can see you. I know that you don't have this thing, and you still don't recognize it. And sometimes it can happen that we don't have something and we thought we have that thing. Something is missing and we fail to recognize it. And sometimes what we would have recovered early enough eventually became a permanent loss because we didn't even know. We didn't even feel the need for us to pursue. Sure, it was because David came back and he saw that this thing was missing. That was missing. His wives were gone. His daughters and his sons were gone. The whole house has been, ransacked and taken away. What if he was blind and he came and he could not even see? What if the enemy stole that thing from him and he did not know? I pray the enemy will not steal your valuables without you being aware. Amen. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And it is important as we recognize it that we do something about it. You see, if we lost something that is of value, we will by all means make efforts. But when we lose something that is not of value, we probably will not do much. Because the more valuable the thing we lost, the more aggressive we will search for it. Take, for instance, somebody that lost 10 cents. Will he make effort to look for it? I had 10 cents in my pocket before. I didn't know where I dropped it. No problem. It's gone. But if he had 100 pounds in his pocket and he looked for it, he didn't see it, by all means, some things will change. And that is the same thing. Whatever you have lost, it depends on the value you place on that thing. And that will, motivate you to begin to search for it. Think about the story of Esau. Esau did not know the value of his birthright. And that was why when he lost that birthright, it didn't bother him until it became too late for him to recover it. Because he just came that day, he was hungry, and he said, I am hungry. Yes, just give me food. That one said, give me your birthright. He said, what is the value of the birthright anyway? Take birthright and give me food. He didn't know. But by the time it was too late, that was when he realized it. You come to Hebrews chapter 12, in verse 16, the Bible says, while he sorted it carefully with tears, there was no space for him. And that's why we need to begin early in the year to begin to count our loss in every area, spiritual, material, familiar, relational, financial. We are looking at it. And we want to start the pursuit early. We want to start the recovery, the effort to recover it early. And I pray the Lord God of heaven, he will help us this evening in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You read the story in 2 Kings chapter 6 about the sons of the prophet. The Bible says they wanted to go to Jordan. You know the story. And eventually they went. And the Bible says they had borrowed an axe so that they could cut down woods to come and build, you know, shelter. As they were cutting the wood, the Bible says the head of the axe fell into the water. And immediately one of the sons of the prophet shouted, "Alas, master, for it was borrowed." They knew the value. Number one, that work would have stopped. Number two, the owner is going to ask them, "Where was the axe you borrowed?" And eventually, God gave them a miracle. And the Bible says the iron swim. Think about the weight of an iron. And he fell into the water. And when the man of God got there, he told that iron, "I don't care the depth that you have gone, how far you have gone, come back up. I pray. The impossible, the Lord will cause you to recover it this year in Jesus' name."
Amen.
The question is, what have you lost? How valuable is that thing that you have lost? Have you lost a son? Have you lost a brother? Sometimes it might not be your biological, it could be a spiritual. Have you lost the axe head that we talked about, which is very valuable? It's a tool. Sometimes that axe head, your axe head is what you need. It's a valuable tool for your productivity, for your progress, for your advancement in life. Have you lost a territory to the enemy? Have you lost your thirst for righteousness? Let me ask you, what is it? Sit down, take an inventory of what you have lost. Because it is when you recognize it, that it becomes easy for you to go and recover. What about trust and intimacy? Whatever it is, have you lost grace and the touch of God upon your life? This evening, we will trust God that it doesn't matter. The Lord God will cause us to recover them in Jesus' name. But recognizing the loss is the first step to recovery. And as we do, the Lord God of heaven, in his mercy, it will cause recovery to start happening in our lives every day of this year in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That brings me to point number two, quickly. Reasons for the loss. You see, people suffer a loss or losses for different reasons. The reason why I suffered a loss might not be the same reason. Why? My loss can be as a result of my carelessness. It can be as a result of maybe a thief coming to steal, not because I was careless, but I kept the thing, but a thief burgled and came in and took that thing away. Yeah, so that I can prevent it, I can say, okay, my security system is bad. Maybe I need a CCTV, maybe I need an alarm. And if it is my door that is not good, I fix it. If I had been careless, I will need to address that carelessness. And that is why it's important. You need to recognize the reason why you suffered the loss or the losses, as your case may be. You must discover the underlying reason behind the loss. And the purpose is to prevent reoccurrence. You don't want it to happen again after you have recovered. Because once you recover it, you want to tell yourself, "This, I'm not going to let it happen again." So, brethren, what is the reason for that loss? You've lost your thirst for righteousness. You've lost your love, the commitment and the love you have for God. You've lost an indispensable tools that you need to be able to do the work that God has committed into your hands. You are asking yourself, why did I suffer this loss? Why did it happen? How did it happen? You have lost a relationship, a very close, good relationship that you once had. A brother, a sister, a son. You are asking. Because by the time the Lord gives us that thing back this year, and I'm trusting He will, I said He will.
Amen.
We don't want to lose it again.
Yes.
In the case of Esau, he lost his birthright because of his appetite, because of lack of discipline. And sometimes people will lose something very valuable as a result of a problem in their life. It can be as a result of, you know, rebellion. It's as a result of not valuing the thing, undervaluing it. You don't have value for it. That's why you will find some people, is when they have lost a friend or maybe lost a wife. Or lost a, and that is when they will say, oh, can you imagine if this person was here? When the person was here, I didn't know the value of this person. Sometimes it's a son that is in the house and he's doing everything and everything. By the time that child is no longer there anymore, you say, oh, my son, I missed my son. And while he was even doing this, I didn't even see it as anything. But brethren, whatever be the reason, we need to ask ourselves and be honest about it. Did you lose the grace of God and the touch of God upon your life as a result of, you know, toiling with sin, as all carelessness? Because it is possible. Think about the story of Esau. As you read the story of Esau, you know how it happened. Because he just lack, you know, discipline. You read the story of the prodigal son, Luke chapter 15. You know what happened. The story of the prodigal son was a sad and pathetic story. He lost that valuable thing in his life because of the deception of the devil. It was the devil that deceived him. He thought there was a better life out there. Yes, come, go. Don't be the restriction in your father's house is too much. The control is too much. Just go. The devil pushed him and deceived him. And many times that's what happens. And many times people don't even recognize it. You come to Judges chapter 16. We'll not open because of our time. The Bible tells us that Samson lost the anointing due to lack of discipline. He was always going this place, that place. If he was not in Gaza, he was in Timnath. He was just, he had no discipline. Cannot say no to women. But my prayer is that the Lord God of heaven, He will help us so that we will not lose whatever we have lost again. By the time the recovery starts, we will not lose it again to the devil in Jesus' name. Amen. Did you lose progress in your life? The progress that you have made, the gains that you have made as a result of this pandemic and this plague that has come upon the world? Of course, the Bible tells us in Revelation chapter 8, but sometimes, yes, that God sometimes is responsible for plagues so that the world can acknowledge Him as God. But also we have the promise of God that when plagues happen, for those that recognizes Him, that acknowledges Him, He will make a way out. And that's what He will do for us in Jesus' name. Did you lose territory as a result of warfare or as a result of foolish greed that made you to sell it out? It's a question we really need to ask. Sometimes we lose our senses and our thinking faculty as a result of pride, as a result of indulgence and arrogance. When you read in Daniel chapter 4, you read the story of Nebuchadnezzar. And the story of Nebuchadnezzar will make anyone to just think, a king that had everything. It was just arrogance toward God. Pride. I have arrived. I don't care about God anymore. Brethren, God is faithful. We will find mercy this evening as we trust him. And he will bring us out of whatever is responsible from that for our losses. And we will recover in Jesus' name. Whatever be the reason for the loss, the mercy of God is what we will trust him for this evening. The mercy of God will bring recovery and restoration. And I pray you will testify of it in Jesus' name. That brings me to the final point. Recovering the lost. This part that I'm going to talk to you about and we will pray, it is a tested and a proven path to recover anything that may have been lost. It is tested. Every time you see people that lost something in the Bible, they tried this thing. When they say something is a tested method of doing something, it is because it has worked repeatedly. And I pray it will work in your life. It will work in my life. First of all, we must put them into categories. And now we begin to seek the face of God. We begin to seek the mercy of God. We begin to seek the power of God. Number one, it will lead us to those places where those losses have happened. Number two, it will cause us to begin to recover. Even if an enemy are taking it by force, they themselves, they will surrender it back. And I pray that you will have a testimony. I say you will have a testimony.
Amen.
And God will be glorified in each of our lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number one, recovering lost tools. I showed you that passage. I didn't read it because of our time. It was in 2 Kings chapter 6. The Bible says the sons of the prophets, they are taking Elijah, that let's just go and do this thing. And what lesson did we learn from that? It is that you must partner with God and God's servants. If those people had lost that axe and Elisha was not there, they are done for. That would have been the end. If they had gone to Jordan to cut down wood without God or the man of God accompanying them, whatever they have lost, that's it. They are not going to recover. Because if Elijah was not there, how is he going to be there? If the presence of God upon the life of Elijah was not there, it would have been wasted. So as much as you can this year, partner with God. Partner with the people of God. It is a partnership that rewards. I have taught repeatedly on the importance of partnership. And I trust God, as you come this year and do what the Bible says we all should do in Psalm 133, verse 1, that when we are united with the people of God and God there, he commended his blessings. And I pray that whatever tool that you have lost, there will be recovery in Jesus' name. Number two is recovery of lost territory. Think about it. Before the COVID started, we were thinking as a church in Motherwell that if the Lord leads us, we will go to Hamilton. In fact, we know without any controversy, our attendance has dropped a lot of people are discouraged and are probably falling or, you know, backsliding or falling away. And it is not just here, it's everywhere. That's why the region is saying that maybe we should all even be going to Glasgow now. Because what is the point if you don't have, you know, let's everybody be going to Glasgow. That territory may appear like we have lost it. Hamilton may look like we have lost it, but we haven't. And we are trusting God that this year we will recover that territory. Amen. Every territory that it appears that we have lost, there will be recovery in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You read in 2 Kings chapter 13, it was the story of Joash and Elisha. And the Bible says, when Joash came, just before the death of Elisha, and he told him that, oh, man of God, you are going to die, what is good? And you see again there, Joash and the man of God. Again, the importance of partnership. Because by inspiration, the man of God told him what he needed to do. He was obedient and he did it. He told him, shoot the arrow of deliverance. So this year, when you say, come, let's do this, don't isolate yourself. Come, receive instruction from the Lord. So as we shoot, I pray, the enemy will not miss your arrow. You will not miss the targets. The enemy will not escape your arrow.
Amen.
And the Lord will cause us to recover every lost territory in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number three, recovery of lost thinking. The prodigal son, the Bible says, came to himself at some point. And that is what we really need to do this year. We need to come to ourselves. We need to abandon, you know, the way of indulgence and rebellious living. And come and say, oh, yes. And that is what God does. When people are losing their mind, they don't have value for spiritual authority. They don't have the value for God. Nothing for them. It doesn't matter. So it matters. If we are still all here, it's just because of God. It's not because we rebel against leadership. It is God. Because we don't see, you know, we see it beyond just, you know, the physical. And I pray, the Lord God of heaven, he will help us that this year, the progress we will make will be accelerated.
Amen.
And we will recover everything that we have lost in yesteryears in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Bible tells us that when Nebuchadnezzar lost his mind after his arrogance, after his rebellion. Only one thing made a difference in his life. What was that thing? The mercy of God. For you this year and for me, the mercy of God. He will rewrite your story.
Amen.
And you will testify of it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Remember the story of the man of Gadara. That man, even though he had no one, he has lost everything, he had no sense of, you know, the ability to understand anything. It was at that point that Jesus found him. And the encounter with God brought sanity back. This year, like no any other year, your close relationship and encounter with God will turn the tides.
Amen.
And the Lord God of heaven will cause a new song, a new testimony to be ringing in our church in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number four, recovery of lost treasure. Have you lost something very precious to you? The Bible tells us the story in Luke chapter 15. Just before the story of the prodigal son, Jesus was speaking to the people, and he told them about the story first that I want you to look at a shepherd that had 100 sheep, and he lost one of them. Do you think that he will not leave the 99 if that those sheeps they have, every single one of them is valuable to him? They are treasures. Nobody wants to diminish. Nobody wants to go from up to down. Everybody, the desire is here. Your numbers are increasing. You are growing. The Bible says, Jesus says that shepherd will leave that 99 and go and look for that single one. When he has found it and brought it back, he says there will be joy as if it's more valuable. And that's what we need to do this very year. We need to exercise diligence. Every effort, we need to exercise it to search for every precious soul that God has given us. They are precious, they are treasures. And we need to make the effort until we have searched for every one of them and count them. We will not rest. And we pray that the Lord will cause us to recover them back in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Bible tells us, as you read in that passage in our text, that David recovered all through what? The promise of God. In verse 8, God gave him a promise. He arose in verse 7, 18 and 19. He came back. And as we have received the promise of God, we will recover every treasure that we have lost in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number 5, recovery of lost time. Of course, we know that a lot of time had been lost this year. So many people, as a result of COVID, as a result of so many things. But we're going to trust God. We'll go to him. We'll tell him to fulfill his promise, the promise that he has made. What is that promise? It's the promise of restoration. Come with me before we pray. Let me show you that promise. In Joel, I know you know the promise of God already. Chapter 2, I read in verse 25. Look at what the Bible says. And it is still new today. The promise is still good even today. Joel chapter 2 in verse 25. He says, and I will restore to you the years. You see, he's talking about time here now. The years, be it in plural, or the year, if it is in singular, that the locusts had eaten. The Lord will restore it. The cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmerworm, my great army, which I sent among you. If you think that coronavirus has eaten 2020, there will be restoration for you.
Amen.
Everything that represents cankerworm, palmerworm, caterpillar, and locust, and every time that you have lost to these things, the Lord will cause us to recover them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Then recovery of lost thirst. Our thirst for God apparently has gone. So many people, in fact, they don't even have any thirst anymore. And we need to pray and trust God to recreate in such kind of people, and even me, myself, including you, to recreate a new heart in our heart, a new heart that we thirst after God, thirst after righteousness, thirst, desire. It doesn't matter how difficult, whatever the challenge may be, we just longing after God. Matthew chapter 5, you read there in verse 6, it says, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for what? They shall be filled. You read in Psalm 51 from verse 10, he says, create in me a new heart, renew the right spirit within me. And it is important. Come with me to that psalm. And this is going to be what, you know, we will be praying and focusing on from verse 10. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. He says, restore, that word again, restoration, unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy spirit. And the Lord will do it. And finally, we will trust God that we will recover lost throne. You know what the Bible says? And it is very, very true. And I trust God that as we believe God and pray tonight, it's our first revival service. Don't be in a hurry. We will have ample time to pray.
Amen.
So you want, we will take all these things one by one. 7 is the number of perfection. And I believe God, there are just 7 of them. And if we pray, they encompass so many things. And we need to pray them one by one. And God, in his might, in his glory, he will cause there to be a recovery in our lives that it will shock you to yourself. And the Lord God will not fail us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As I talk to you about recovering lost throne, you know, many times the Christian, even though God, when he created us, the Bible says he made us in our image. You read in Genesis chapter 1, and it says, let us, you come to verse 26, let us make, you know, man in our own image after our likeness. And the Bible says, let them have dominion over this, over dominion over every other thing. And the Bible says, by the time you come to verse 28, when God has finished, he says, and God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful, be multiply, replenish the earth, subdue it. And the truth is that how many of us are living in that reality? And we have an opportunity. That was the throne that God gave to us that we lost through sin, through carelessness, through disobedience, through arrogance and pride towards God. Not only that, the Bible makes it very clear that you know it is possible. And in fact, the preacher says that I have seen it happen. This evil, I have seen it happen. What is that evil? Come with me before we pray to Ecclesiastes. Let me quickly show you. Then we'll go to the Lord in prayer. In chapter 10, let me read from verse 5. There is an evil which I have seen under the sun as an error which proceeded from the ruler. Fully is set in great dignity, and the rich sit in a low place. Look at in verse 7. I have seen servants upon horses, and princes walking as servants upon the head. That will not be you. I say, may that not be you. Any individual, be it a satanic agent or a principality of himself, that is dethroned any child of God. And he has asked the child of God, come down from your throne, and he's climbing it. Or come down from your horse, and he's riding on the horse. Why you, the owner of the horse, you are walking on the ground? This evening, the Lord will dethrone them.
Amen.
I say heaven will dethrone them.
Amen.
That's why it's good. We have the opportunity during this first service of the year to seek the face of God. And I trust God that there will be recovery in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's rise up on our feet and call upon the Lord. Let's begin to talk to the Lord this very evening. We are here for recovery. Recovery of the lost. Talk to the Lord. Talk to the Lord. Call upon the Lord. That the Lord God of heaven, in his mercy, in his power, he will cause recovery to happen in your life. Begin to recognize that loss. Begin to tell God, yes, truly I recognize that this thing as is not the same. My spiritual life is not the same. My financial life is not the same. My family life is not the same. My career, my ministry is not the same. I recognize it, O Lord. And I, Lord, I trust you this very evening. Oh, yes. Lord, I come and I say, God, in all contrition, in all humility, in all honesty, I lost it because of my pride. I lost it deep because of my sin. I lost it because of my disobedience. I lost it, Lord, because of my carelessness. I recognize it. I recognize it. And I am sorry, Lord. Talk to the Lord. Those are the things we need to do tonight before we begin to pray for the recovery, because that recovery, either the devil likes or not, it will take place. It will happen to you. It will happen to me. Talk to the Lord in prayer. Recovery, recovery. I recognize it. I recognize it. Lord, I am sorry for the loss. I am sorry for how I lost this valuable, precious thing that you gave me once. And this evening, Lord, I am trusting you. Oh, yes, that there will be a recovery in the name of the Lord Jesus. It doesn't matter how long it has been lost. Tonight, Lord, let there be a recovery in the name of the Lord Jesus. Pastor Emmanuel, talk to the Lord in prayer. Talk to the Lord in prayer that this evening you won't go away until the Lord God has restored back everything that, oh yes, the pandemic, the plague, the lockdown, whatever it is, has taken. The Lord will do it in your life.
In Jesus' name we pray. I think we have had it all, because this message is quite inspiring and we are getting the message at the right time. The Lord bringing us into the new year is a very wonderful victory. He wants us to be fulfilled in life. That is why he brought us to this very year. And a message like this is for what we need, you know, to tap into divine resources and also to recover all. And I thank God, the servant of God have break down all the counsel of the Lord in the simplest way that we can understand. And also the first prayer point he laid now is the foundation of recovery. Really, last year has been a very big challenging year. Not only that what happened did not happen by accident. Like where he read in Joel chapter 2, God was talking about years, not only 2020. So, but we have done what we need to do by humbling ourselves before the Lord. Whatever mistake, whatever misconduct, whatever negligence or whatever that may lead to the enemy robbing us what belongs to us, as we have come to the Lord in humble heart, in contrite mind, you know, God have acknowledged, God have pardoned. So now we are going to pray and call upon the Lord that all the lost territory that we've lost, you know, that have linger for years, that this very year the Lord will replenish them all. I want you to talk to the Lord this hour, because the right step to take is to acknowledge, as the servant of God says, when you realize that you've lost something and you are eager to recover, that is what it means to return to the Lord. Returning to the Lord shows that you have discovered that something is already going wrong, and the only one that can bring it back is the Lord. So that acknowledgement is very, very important. And as we've done that, and we've repented and sincerely repented, promising the Lord that this year is a year of solid covenant with him. Brethren, it is time now to speak to the Lord. To speak to him for total recovery. David took the same step. He made the same way we read in our text. He didn't just went and say, these people have taken all our belongings. Let's just pursue them. No. David said, you know, people were crying and even were thinking of how to stone him. He didn't even, you know, dispute with them. He didn't quarrel with them. He sought the Lord. He knew that there is nothing in the sight of the Lord that will be counted lost. The only thing that will be counted lost is when we have decided not to seek the Lord. That virtue has gone and gone forever. So with the principles of David, I think we can tap something that will help us also to be like David. In our text this night, he said, you know, he sought the Lord, and the Lord told him, pursue and recover all. And eventually he went and he recovered all. Irrespective of the fact that these people have brought that very, you know, they have done that evil, can I say hours or days back. But God being God, he knew those things, they were all intact. And when we read in 19, verse 19 and thereabout, he says he recovered everything, nothing missing. But that shows you, that gives you the assurance that, yeah, if you can believe the Lord, based on the prayer we've prayed, based on the repentance we've already, you know, repented, basically, all the things that have been, I mean, we've lost past years, the Lord will restore them. This is 2020, where the servant of the man of God have said that all our bitterness will turn to sweetness. And you can see the type of message we've just had this night. Brethren, why don't you now pray? Because this is not just ordinary word. It's not the word of man's wisdom. This is by divine inspiration. Because the Lord who brought us this year knows that by his own power, we will recover all. And he brought something like a message like this. We need to pray. It didn't just come by accident. It come by inspiration. And that inspiration, I want you to tap for me and say, I mean, personalize it. This message is for me. This 2021, all the things that I've lost since even I come to this hero, this year the Lord will compensate me with it, because he has already made it clear. If he can restore all to David, if he can speak to us in Joel chapter 2, verse 25, then with faith to pray. That means we are already, God forbid, that's not our portion. We are winners, and we are meant to be winners. Brethren, you need to pray. You need to pray seriously and earnestly so that the Lord will dismantle. He will lay ambush. He will bulldoze all the barriers, all the cloud that have been beclouding all our resources, and he will see them coming down in this very year. In the mighty name of Jesus, pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Once again, we are going to pray for divine restoration. You know, restoration of our right thinking. Right thinking is very, very important. Sometimes someone may think that he is, you know, the Bible said there is a way that seems right to man, but to God it's an abomination. So that is why we need to pray for the Lord to restore our right thinking. Remember the demon of Gadara? All sort of demons, you know, entered him. Somebody that was meant to be, to be a hero eventually became a prey to demons. But when Christ met him, he came back to his normal senses. He became a mighty evangelist. You can see what God can do when the normal senses, I mean, is restored. And you are going to pray, all that associated with my normal thinking, normal reasoning, the Lord will restore it, because it is important. There are some inspiration that you ought to have, but for the fact that the body or the spirit is not right, it's not how God meant it to be, so the inspiration will not come. But when once God has stepped in, he removes all counterfeit and he brings his wisdom. Remember what Bible says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. That is the wisdom that Daniel used to prevail in the land of Babylon. That is the wisdom that Mr. Shetek and Abednego, they used to prevail in a foreign land. That is it. When God gives you normal, you have divine, spirit, and it's a spirit of excellence. So, brethren, you need to pray. It is something that we need this year, you know, for God to restore, for God to restore our mindset, so that it will be in line with his own, you know, his own counsel, so that whatever he speaks, it will digest in our soul, in our spirit. There will be nothing to, you know, to truncate them. This year is not the year we will be facing all that kind of, you know, satanic manipulation. This year is the year that we will see how God will give us inspiration, and that inspiration we will follow. There is nothing that will come to whisper that, yeah, do you see this cannot be possible? Brethren, these are all that we need to pray about. It is what we have lost for a long time. It's what we have not been enjoying. And today the power of God has brought it to our disposal that we have access to this. Do we know that we can be, we can be great inventors? There is no other power behind all what you are seeing today in this universe. It is by divine inspiration, and we are the children of God, and therefore I've been using, you know, one thing or another to wave all those, you know, benefit away from us. But today, brethren, we are going to pray because this is the beginning of the year. Today is the first revival of the year, and we must get all that have been, you know, unleashed to us today. This message I'm telling you is not just by accident. It is designed by the Lord that we will receive it today, and we will take it as I've received it. Pray and the Lord will establish it, because he is a covenant-keeping God. In Jesus' name we pray. The covering lost treasures. You see, a lot of people has been working hard, like, you know, an elephant and just sleeping like a grasshopper. This year it will not be the same. This year we will receive divine, you know, mercy. You remember the parable of our Lord Jesus Christ, where a rich man hired laborers, and those laborers, he went as early as possible to gather some people, and at the dying minute, he went also to gather some other people. When the work was about a few hours to end, he went and gathered other people, and at the end, he started with the first. The one that wrought few hours, he paid them mightily. The one that were hired earlier thought, maybe, today we have made millions. Eventually, he gave them the same. That is divine, you know, the divine favor, divine mercy, paying beyond your level. This year, the Lord will do it, because that is the restoration. That is when you have not labored and God gives you what other people have been laboring for years. It is possible, because that is what Jesus Christ told us in the parable. That is it. Pray this hour. All our lost treasure, this year the Lord will restore them, because he has given us his word. And we're standing upon his promises in John chapter 2, verse 25, where he said, all that the canker worm have eaten, all that the palmer worms have eaten, all that the caterpillars, he will restore them. God is not a liar. This is the year. This is the year that our bitterness have already gone to sweetness. And we don't need to take chances today. We need to pray and talk to the Lord. As you have heard this message, it didn't just come by accident. You want us to be, you know, to be resourceful, because Bible said that we shall make our prayer unto him and he will hear us and will pray our Father. And we shall decree on a thing and it shall be established on us. And the light shall shine on our way. This year, 2021, that light must shine in the mighty name of Jesus. All that have been in the camp of the enemy. You see, we have been struggling and laboring and laboring. He will be there and smiling and laughing. Yeah, I know where you are. To this year, fire of the Holy Ghost will chase them away, and we don't need to labor. All what we need is just, God. God sending our resources down to our doorstep, and we're receiving them without any struggle. Brethren, that is why you must pray, because prayer is the key. That is the weapon of our warfare. The Bible says that it's not carnal, but mighty through him. If you can't pray, that means you don't have that weapon. You may be thinking that maybe you need a gun or you need a whatever, but that is not what we need. What we need is the prayer. Prayer is the weapon that cannot be defeated. It's mighty through God, the pulling out of every stronghold, casting down imagination and all that they saw is safe. Again, the knowledge of God, bringing to captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Says God, thank you, Lord. God, to tell us to suffice in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to pray for the lost, recovering lost time. You see, just similar like the first one, times, you know, we are buying time every year the same. All that have transpired in those indeed every year the same. This year is the year that will be smiling. It's the year that will be no laughing and rejoicing, because this is our time. We are no longer going to be buying time. Maybe 2020, what? It's like, you know, it's like 30 minutes, because all our expectations, all our dreams, all our aspirations, they were all turned upside down. This year is no longer like that. God Almighty will bring abundance to us. We are all the lost times, all the lost times. Pray that the Lord will restore them this year. This is the year that we have already, you know, been receive the promises of God. That is the year of no sweetness. Sweetness in everywhere. We don't need to be worried about anything. All we need to be worried about is to pray tonight that the God of heaven, who is a covenant-keeping God, this year, we are no longer going to buy time any longer. This year, the Lord that make it 1,000 years like a year, and we a year like 1,000 years. This is the year that he will use to incorporate. He will use to package all the resources of 1,000 years and bring it under a few minutes. That is what God can do, because it is in the scripture, and there is no doubt about all the prayer points we are praying, because this is the word of God. He, in his sight, 1,000 years, when it is going, it's like a day. So there is nothing lost in his sight. So if he says that, yeah, we will recover all the lost time, it is possible, because he's the God of timing. He knows everything about time. He has already said that 1,000 years is like a day unto him. Then this year, brethren, there is nothing that we've lost that will not be recovered. In Jesus' name, we pray. Recovering lost past. You see, it is very, very important. Sometimes many of us, we struggle to pray. And inside our heart, we really want to serve the Lord. But struggling, praying is not, it ought not to be. But that is the characteristics of where we are in the world. Jesus says, from the time of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence. I don't even want to take it by force. You may have the desire to serve the Lord, but if you are not determined, if you have not, you know, if you have not made up your mind to fight that enemy like a wounded lion. You see, when somebody have, just like a dog, you know, you are somewhere and the dog is doing, and then you don't know, if you can just take off with all your strength, you shout on that dog, you see the dog will flee. So that is the aggressiveness that you need to grab divine empowerment. That is what you need for the devil or what demon to do or to give way. Because you cannot see a man with nine hot glass, you try to near him. No, that is what you, violence is something that you know you aggressively. So we are going to pray. But all the lost, we are going to recover from our lost past. We have been fasting to serve the Lord. We have been fasting for righteousness. And righteousness is what God has promised us already. He said, we the father of this world, if we know how to give good gift to our children, what about our heavenly father? Who gives his spirit to those that ask? Brethren, what makes it to be a struggling matter? Brethren, it is because we have not understand that the devil is not joking. Devil just want to try all his effort to see if we are determined to get what we want. And this night, we are going to pray. Anywhere we've been struggling in our spiritual life, that the power that breaks every yoke tonight, he will strangle them. He will suffocate them. He will bury them. This year we will not struggle. The power of the Holy Ghost will strengthen us. Even when we are weary, the supernatural power will come in and wake up, you know, strengthen us. What I know, Jesus Christ fasted 40 days and 40 nights. He was still strong. Moses fasted 40 days in the month. He was still strong. Who made it to be so? It was God. And this year, he said, blessed are he that is thirsty. After I just said, for he shall be filled. So what are we talking about? God has already given us his word to tell us his mind. What his mind, what he has for us, what he wants, what he has already designed for us. And it is time for us to pray that this year will not be like past years, where every year we are still struggling to serve the Lord. This year, the power of God who has suppressed the enemy will ginger our spirits, will take away every lukewarmness, will take away every weariness, will take away every weakness, and empower us with supernatural power, so that we will bounce and bounce like people that are being, you know, motivated and empowered by the Holy Ghost. If you are empowered by the Holy Ghost, that will be nothing like weariness, because you will be too hot for the devil. You will be absolutely too hot for the devil. He will not come near to suffocate or to, you know, to snuff one, to, you know, to make one to be, you know, to be dozing. This year, that is what we have prayed for. God will do it and you fulfill it. So that by the end of the year, we'll look back and say, yes, God will thank you. Because you started the year for us in a way it should be. We started with great message and great revival message. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And finally, we're going to pray recovering lost thrones. You see, Pastor, I've read, you know, he talked about a servant being on a horse, whereas the prince will be walking, you know, and it's an abomination. This year, every stranger riding on my horse, this year, even right from now, the Lord will not see them in the mighty name of Jesus. Every stranger that is on my horse, then the Lord, let the power, let the Spirit of God right now grab them on the neck and throw them right in the dungeon straight away, because it has already been declared that this year they will no longer do what they've been doing in the yesteryears. Pray this hour, every stranger in my house tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus, you are seated in the name of Jesus, because this is the year of our great throne, the recovering of every throne that the Lord has bestowed for us and our children, for our families. Yes, the benefit of serving the Lord. Can see who said that we will be the head and not the tail? He is who said that we shall be above and not beneath? He who said that we shall keep to many nations and will not borrow? He says what he means, and tonight, every stranger sitting on those very promises and those things that God already has released, through the day we had our salvation, the day we are seated with the Spirit of the living God, and still be struggling because of one thing or another, or ancestral power, or compromise, or whatever, tonight, oh God, as you have fallen, release your hand of mercy and forgiveness. Let every power, oh Lord, that have been sitting on our belonging and our resources and our inheritance, oh Lord, let the fire from heaven drive them right now, right to their possession, the dust of defeat, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, we praise you, Lord, because you may have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Over to you, sir, because of our time.
Let's begin to thank the Lord. Let's thank the Lord. Let's thank the Lord. Let's bless the name of the Lord. I don't know about you. I believe in prayer. And prayer is seeking the face of God. The prayer of tonight, let's trust God that it will move the mountain in the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh, yes. There is nothing prayer cannot do. Jesus has answered our prayer tonight. Bless the name of the Lord. Magnify the name of the Lord. Exalt the name of the Lord. That in your life, oh yes, the recovery has started in the name of the Lord Jesus. Recovery. Oh yes, of your mind, of sanity, recovery of time has started. Recovery of your treasure, it has started. The recovery of every lost throne, it has started. Which territory did you lose last year? Oh yes, the recovery has started. Talk to the Lord in prayer that, oh yes, everywhere you turn, this year you will recover. You will recover. There will be restoration. Oh, yes, the limitation and the setback as a result of this pandemic. Oh, yes, pray that the Lord is reversing it. Thank the Lord for reversing it in the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh, yes, progress in your academics. Everything that this pandemic has done to the life of every one of us, the Lord God of heaven, He will delete it and He will cause us to recover it in the name of the Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Lord God, we thank you this evening. Thank you because you have started your work in our lives. And we pray that this year, that work that you have started in each of our life today, the work of recovery, the work of restoration,
amen.
Lord, we pray that you will perfect it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Give us a testimony, O Lord.
Yes, Lord.
That we will look back and say, oh, yes, the time that we're lost, I recovered by God.
Yes.
The family, the properties, everything, relationship that I have lost, I recover it back.
Amen.
The treasure and the territory and the throne that you have given us, the place of dominion, that you have given to us, Lord, we pray. That dominion you will restore back unto us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Pray for our brethren that are not here tonight. Wherever they be, Lord, pray that you will remember them too.
Amen.
And you cause us as a church, brothers, sisters, youth, children, to have a testimony of what you have done to turn this situation around for our good in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord, because we know you have answered. We have heard the reports that the infection is going up. That today alone, over 1,000 deaths in the UK. We come under your everlasting hand, Lord.
Yes, Lord, under your hand.
We pray that, Lord, your hand will shield us.
Amen.
That everlasting hand of God will be above, around, and beneath us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And Lord, we ask of you that in your mercy, as you cause the plague in Egypt, not only not to come to the dwelling of your people, but at some point, Lord, you stayed that plague. We are praying that you will weaken the hand of this plague in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Keep your church, O Lord. Keep our family members. Keep the world from this calamity so that they may know that you are God. Do it and let your name be glorified.
Amen.
For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
And the church of God says,
Amen.